This is an older section of Sarajevo, as you see it from the top of the luge course on Mount Trebević. There are mosques down there built when this land was ruled by the Turks centuries ago. Today, however, our attention is on a different sort of architecture, a building called the Start House. Here, the competitors wait their turns for the solitary plunge down the mountain. Inside, the racers change into their special clothes. The atmosphere appears convivial because luge is a sport where psyching is very much a part of the game. You must never let your opponents know your doubts. But these are not casual moments. They say you'll remember, years later, the exact spot you sat in the Start House. The sleds wait in the room below, each of their curving steel runners laboriously hand-polished. Because weight translates into speed, the rules provide a handicapping system, allowing lighter riders to balance themselves with a vest weighted with lead. Suits are made of thin, plastic-coated nylon, and the tighter they fit, the better. It means less aerodynamic drag. But the need to cheat the wind restricts you to the most minimal padding and protective equipment. Narrow, treadless boots, again for aerodynamics, although they might be more appropriate at a ballet. Oddly incongruous are the spiked gloves that Spartacus might have worn. They're for pushing off at the start. Finally, the visor is cleaned with an anti-fogging solution. A last chance to concentrate. Eyes closed, you imagine the track, turn by turn, programming yourself for the perfect run. Downstairs now, your heart pounding. Danger and the possibility of a crash has been thrust from your mind. In a minute, your rivals, still waiting their turn upstairs, will hear your time, know what you've done, but you don't think of that now. At the green light, using every ounce of strength, you hurl yourself forward and are alone on the ice. Hundreds of feet below is the finish line, drawing you toward it now like a magnet. Go, go. Sport of luge. It's still relatively unknown in the United States, where there are fewer than 300 participants, but it's very popular in East Germany, West Germany, Austria, Northern Italy, and most recently, it's become popular in the Soviet Union. Hi, I'm Sam Posey, and we're just moments to go now before the start of the men's singles competition. The format is very simple, really. Each competitor will make one run per day for 4 days. And the winner will be the man with the lowest elapsed time for those 4 runs. Working with me today as our expert on the sport of luging is Jeff Tucker. Jeff is a former national champion and was the highest placed American on the American luge team in the Winter Olympics in Lake Placid 4 years ago. Now, Jeff, the first man down the hill today is going to be an American, Frank Maisley. And less than 24 hours ago, Frank was carrying the flag in the opening ceremonies for the Olympics. Obviously, an incredible moment for him. Now, as a former Olympian yourself, can you give us some idea what he must be going through as he tries to readjust from the excitement of that moment to what he has to do here?
Well, walking into an opening ceremonies as a member of the U.S. Olympic team is just an incredible experience. Carrying the flag, well, that's just fabulous. That's something Frank will carry with him for the rest of his life. What he's got to do now, though, is carry over the enthusiasm, the excitement into this race, but he's also got to put some of that behind him. He's got to focus his attention and concentrate on the 4 runs he has over 4 days. He's really, really got to apply himself.
Do you think he has any chance?
Well, Frank's done very well in international competition. He's risen through the ranks. He's had some good finishes. But as you know, the competition here is going to be between the very strong Russian team of Yuri Harchenko and Sergei Danilin and the Italians, Paul Hildegardner, Ernst Haspinger. It's going to be an exciting race. They've been neck and neck in training, trading off the fastest run. I think we're going to have a great race soon.
The face you see, Frank Maisley, 4-time national luge champion in the United States. 6 feet 1 inches tall, 185 pounds. He's from Newark, Delaware. You know, he's a true amateur and in every way embodies the spirit of the Olympics. And we had a chance to talk to him about a moment that was very special in his life yesterday when he carried the flag in the opening ceremony.
I never expected to have this honor to carry the flag. And my fellow athletes gave me the position to carry the flag, and it's a big day for luge, I think, also, the sport of luge. We've never carried the flag before, and my athletes put me in there. My fellow luge athletes picked me, and then the whole American team picked me, and I'm just so happy, and I'm proud to be an American.
On the right of your screen with Frank Maisley there, Sven Rumstad, the very young, just 23-year-old coach of the U.S. luge team. Frank Maisley, obviously a very hot prospect for this year and for the Calgary Games beyond. Now, Frank had a personal best time down the run, Jeff, a couple of days ago. There's just 1 second off the track record set by Paul Hilgartner. So this could be very, very important. Of course, this is the moment he's waited for so long, trained for 4 years. There's been so much publicity, so much anticipation. Now he must put it on the line.
Well, that's right, Sam. It's showtime for Frank, and he knows that. He's a seasoned competitor. He seems to rise to the occasion. I think we're going to see a very good run from him. Of course, it's the first man down. We haven't seen anybody else yet come down, but great start for him, Sam. Very nice start for him. Right back into the position. Super aerodynamic position there. Head all the way back, toes pointed. Let's see his first splits coming up.
All right, the upper part of the track. Very important before they really gather a lot of speed, not to make any mistakes, not to hit the walls at all, because you scrub off so much speed before you really build up that rush of energy later in the course. There's the first split time, 21.3. We'll be watching those as the competition develops. But Frank now coming onto the long straightaway where speeds of about 70 miles an hour will be hit here.
He looks great, Sam. He nailed this straightaway right down the middle. It's a tough turn nine and into the labyrinth. It's a tricky section from the men's start.
There's the labyrinth turn, right to left to right, and now he's out onto the last turn of the track, the finish turn.
It's a terrific run for him, Sam, a 46.89 with the snow on the track. That's really a fabulous run for Frank. He's got to be very pleased with that. It was clean all the way down. He drove good lines, maintained a good aerodynamic position. So his teammate, who's currently in first.
All right,
let's see how he does.
He's never won on this track, Jeff, but he's won everything else over the last few months. If there is anybody coming into this competition that could be described as hot, it's Danilin right here. 24 years old, the best man the Russians have, as we understand it.
That's true. But Harshenko will also give a run for the money. That's the classic Danilin start right there. Quick off the handle, a few quick paddles, and right down the position. He's smooth up the top.
All right,
loose on the sled, and the aerodynamics are absolutely perfect.
All right, now some people think that you just coast down here, but in fact, they're steering.
They're steering all the way down the track, and that's tough, Sam, because there are big G-turns in these curves. Their bodies are getting pressed, their legs are getting pushed in the ice, their head's getting pushed down.
Okay, it's a new record split time off the top. Sergei Danilin has just gone faster over the early part of the track than his teammate Harshenko, so he is making an excellent run as he works through that ninth turn there and starts into the lap.
And that's just perfect luge form right there.
Whoa,
he had trouble again.
He went high there. All right, we see him at the finish. No, he does not take the lead, Jeff. That is where the mistake was made, right there in the labyrinth. He got too high, am I correct?
You're absolutely correct, and that's very uncharacteristic of Sergei Danilin. He usually comes down like he's on rails. He's lucky he didn't crash there, Sam. He is lucky he didn't go over and blow it all. He made a good recovery, and he's in second place, but still a surprise.
Well, they're going to take a moment to sweep the snow out of the run. Earlier, with the help of Carl Rupke, Jeff demonstrated just how a luge is steered.